the testing and the performance. Now we are seeing the testing and the performance. Why the testing is required? What is the objective to get the testing? So first objective is to get the information like basics, design information of the engine. Second one is to justify the operation of the engine with the specific fuel consumption, to verify and confirm the validity of the engine data used in the designing the engine, and to match the performance parameter with the design specification. So that there are some important parameters of the ICE engine. Some of the information important parameters of the ICE engine. The first one is the power and the mechanical efficiency. Second one is the mean effective pressure and the torque, specific output, volumetric efficiency, air fuel ratio, specific fuel consumption, thermal efficiency and the heat balances, balance sheet, exhaust smokes and other emission, and specific weight. Now you will see the indicated power. What is indicated power? Indicated power is the power developed within the cylinder by burning of the fuel. Or indicated power can be measured by the three methods, which are indicated diagram, by measuring the friction power and the brake power, and addition of that both power, means indicated power is equal to brake power plus friction power, and by the MOSFETs. Like this, the indicated power is developed inside the engine by burning up the fuel, and the friction power is the loss of power due to the friction losses, and the mechanical losses and the transmission losses. And the brake power is the power available at the end of the crankshaft, mean the output power. We can say the brake power is the output power. The indicated power obtained at the cylinder, obtaining from the indicated diagram, where indicated power is given by PIM LAN N divided by 60 in watt, where the P is the indicated mean effective pressure in Newton per meter, L is the length of the stroke in meter, A is the area of the cross section, means pi by 4 D square in the meter square, NS is the engine speed in revolution per minute, N is equal to N by 2 for the 4 stroke engine, and N for the 2 stroke engine, and N is the number of cylinder, and the work produced per the cycle by the piston is the mean force acting on the pistons into the piston displacement in the stroke, by means the force on the piston is equal to PIM into A. Okay, then so work done per stroke is equal to force into distance into, so force is equal to PIM into A, and the distance is equal to L. So we can get the work done per cycle per second is equal to work done per stroke into the number of working stroke per second. So we can get the work produced per the cycle by the piston is PM into A into L. Now work produced per minute by the piston is the work done per cycle into the number of cycle per minute. So PIM into A into L into N joule. So indicated power is given by PIM into A into L into N joules or watt. So next is the mean effective pressure. What do you mean mean effective pressure? The mean effective pressure is the quantity related to the operation of the reciprocating engine. N is value, measure of engine capacity to do work that is independent of the engine displacement. So indicated mean effective pressure, or IMEP, it may be defined as the average pressure over the cycle in the combustion chamber of the engine. So to calculating the mean effective pressure, P1 is equal to net work of cycle per the swept volume in the Newton per meter square. So PMEP is equal to PM is equal to PIM. Let W is equal to work per cycle in joule, P is equal to power output in watt, PMEP mean effective pressure in the Pascal, VD displacement of volume in the cubic meter, NC is the number of revolution per cycle for the four stroke engine, NC is equal to 2, N is equal to number of revolution per second, and the T is equal to torque into Newton and Newton into meter. Since W is equal to PNC upon N, W is equal to PMEP into VD, so we can get PMEP PNC upon VD upon N. Since we can get the P is equal to pi N 2 pi NT. So power is equal to 2 pi NT. And so mean effective pressure is equal to TNC divided by VD into 2 pi. And the mean effective pressure is also obtained from the engine indicator diagram as PM is equal to S into A divided by L is Newton per meter square, where the A is equal to actual indicator diagram centimeter square, L is equal to base width the indicator diagram in the centimeter, S equal to spring value or the spring tension used in the indicator diagram Newton per meter square divided by centimeter. So break effective pressure BMEP is the mean effective pressure. Now we will see the friction power. What is friction power? The friction power is induced the friction losses and the pumping losses during the suction and the exhaust stroke. The piston must move against the gaseous pressure and power required to do this called the pumping losses. As well as the friction losses is made up of the energy losses due to the friction between the piston and the cylinder wall, piston rings and the cylinder wall, and between the crankshaft and the camshaft and their bearings, as well as by the loss incurred by the driving and the essential accessories such as water, pump, ignition unit, transmission, etc. Following method are used to measure the friction power or measuring the friction losses. First one is Williamson line method. Second one is from the measurement of indicated power and the brake power. In this method, first we have to find the indicated power and then the brake power, and by then get the difference of indicated power and the brake power, we can get the friction power, motoring test and the retardation test. So we are going to learn about the Williamson line method. In Williamson line method, in this method is also known as the fuel rate extrapolation method. In this method, a graph of fuel consumption versus the brake power is drawn and it is extrapolated on the negative axis of the brake power. In this method, it is used for the compressed ignition engine, or we can say CI engine. A graph between the fuel consumption versus torque at the constant speed is plotted as shown in the figure. So on the x-axis we can get the engine torque, and the y-axis we can take the fuel consumption. And from the graph, during the idling condition, engine produced the power, produced no power per torque. There is some fuel required to overcome the friction of the engine. Okay, in order to get the friction torque, graph is extrapolated means the graph is extended in the negative axis like that. Okay, so a graph is extended in the negative axis. We can say in order to get the friction torque, graph is extrapolated on the back side of the zero fuel consumption or the negative size, the point of interaction means this point to the torque or the brake power axis indicated in the friction torque or the friction power. So the main, but there are some drawback also. The main drawback of this method is the long distance to be extrapolated from the data between the 5 and the 40% load towards the zero line of the fuel input. And the direction margin of error is rather wide because of the graph is not exactly linear, because we can see that the curvature. And the second method is the from the measuring of the indicated power and the brake power independently. This is an ideal method by which the friction power is obtained by the computing the difference between the indicated power and the brake power. The indicated power is obtained from the indicated diagram and the brake power is obtained by the brake dynamometer. This method required the elaborated equipment to obtain the accurate indicated diagram at the high speed.